In this video, we're talking about how to flip houses with no money down and how complete beginners are earning an extra $30,000 a month with no experience. More of that after the intro. Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Mike Facile. Welcome to this video. Before we actually begin, to remind you that several spots have opened up for this week's free workshop, where it's literally the fastest and the easiest way to make money online. Sign up for it in the link below. We have a 62-year-old woman go from zero to 160 grand profit in 90 days, so sign up for it in the link below. So I remember when I was younger, I would literally see my dad struggle with real estate. You know, he was working as an engineer and making his money that way, but for some reason, no matter how hard he worked, we never had enough money to make ends meet, right? So he would literally go and start a bunch of like real estate side hustles from like trying to attempt to flip houses and trying to go ahead and, for example, rent property out. The only downside was we literally had no money. So it was very interesting to see all the ways that he was trying to, for example, flip houses with no money down, and how I literally saw and learned from that and realized how I could pivot it and even use that in the online world to, for example, make money with no money down. And I want to compare both strategies because both work. Like you could see in one couple like online businesses that use kind of like the real estate model, but like in the online world, we pulled in about like $35,000 to $46,000 per month. Another business, we went from zero to $5,000 in that first month to $1.6 million that first year. And another digital real estate business, we went from zero to $8,000 in 30 days. And I'm gonna explain more about that later on, but I really wanna compare that to this article that I was reading on Fortune Builders, and I'll put the links in the links below on the 8 ways to start flipping houses with no money. Because this is literally what my dad would read over and over and over again to try to make the money with real estate so that he could provide for, you know, me and my sister. And the, like I said, the biggest problem is not having that money. And I think that stops people so much. They want to get into some type of business and they get excited. They're like, oh my God, you know, I could go and make money. I could create freedom for myself. I could provide for my family. And then they find out how much it costs and they're a little bit overwhelmed and a little bit scared and they give up before they get started. So sometimes when you have no money, that's okay and that's fine, because what you do have is creativity. If you could find creative solutions for these exact businesses that people are using to actually spend money on, you could actually position yourself in a way that you could actually capitalize and leverage other people's money to make money without you putting any of your money down. So I wanna break these down. And as you can see, Fortune Builders is like a place where a lot of people go ahead and, for example, learn about real estate stuff. Check it out in the link below. But you can see house flipping is a process of real estate, which it means an investor purchases a property, makes repairs, and then sells it for a profit. This investment strategy is intended for an investor to sell the property as fast as possible instead of using the property to actually live in. House flipping is generally the most lucrative when an investor can locate an undervalued home, add purchase it for a below market value, and receive the highest possible bid once the property is repaired and put it back on the market, right? So this is literally what people even do with, like, for example, products, right? People literally do products where they, for example, would get something in Walmart, they would make it look better, and then they would sell it at eBay for a profit. You can see this, look at this, $242, and then you can see $199. You could see that there is a difference in terms of market and a difference of prices. And even if you have no money down, you can literally come into here and make money, for example, with physical products. This is what people are doing with, for example, real estate, right? When people are doing it in real estate, they gotta understand that what works online also works offline. Same way how people could sell products, for example, on eBay, wait for the money to return, and, for example, you know, buy it at a lower cost. There are certain physical real estate models that kind of like model these certain philosophies. Now, of course, this isn't financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. This is some guy talking on YouTube, but these are just all the things that I'm learning as I'm, for example, increasing my like IQ in terms of making money. Does that make sense? Now, talking about how much does it cost to flip a house? The main costs include renovation, expenses, insurance, utilities, marketing, and the condition upon it was purchased will determine the scope of work necessary to rehab it, right? And you can see the 8 ways to flip houses with no money and bad credit. So the first thing that they talk about is private lenders. So this will serve as an investor's greatest source of funding. And how, for example, like my friend did it, right? Like here in Bali is like really interesting because you meet a lot of like smart people. Like for example, this guy that makes $1 million per month profit, and this girl that's 11 years old turned on $30 million, right? But some of the people that I interviewed that did this method, they found private lenders because they literally, he was in the Texas market, right? He found a list of all of these like people that wanted to go ahead and invest in real estate. And what he would do is he would literally buy each one of them dinner,
right? So he would buy them dinner, he would speak in front of them, it would be here, he would be him right here, and then the investor right there. And he would literally ask them what their problem was and what deals were they looking for. He asked them what their pain points was, and he built a relationship with these people. The reason why is because these people want to deal, but they don't necessarily want to be the one that goes out there and, you know, organizes the deal. So what he did is he would find all these private lenders. And then once he would go and buy them all tacos, he would literally go and find all these distressed sellers and then buy all those distressed sellers tacos and be like, hey, why do you want to sell your property, right? And then he would see how low he could get that in terms of price, and he would see how much money those like private lenders would give them. And ultimately, because it's he built the relationship between those two networks, was he able to arbitrage the value and actually make money with no money down, right? He just used a little bit of creativity and found people with money but no time to actually go ahead and, for example, find these deals, and people with the deals but had no time or money to go ahead and find people to go ahead and get their properties, and they have no idea about marketing. Just doing this one creative thing alone allowed him to, for example, travel, and that's why I met him in Bali, because he had this like real estate thing that's doing well for himself. The second one is hard money lenders. So these are simply lending companies that offer specialized short-term real estate backed loans. Unlike private money counterparts, they're actually affiliated with a company that specializes in lending. Now, the only downside is they might come with like a higher percentage in terms of interest and upfront fees. So that's why people, like, for example, might not like it, because of the fact that if you can't find a way to pay them back, you're gonna have to rack up a lot of like interest, right? The third one is, for example, wholesaling. Now, wholesaling is really interesting because it's kind of like the online, it's the offline dropshipping model, right? So back in the day, how I would make money is, I would literally copy and paste pictures on Walmart and throw them up on eBay. And then when I would make a sale, I would get the buyer's information as well as the money, and I would buy it at the lower cost and then ship it directly to them, and I would just pocket the difference. Wholesale is kind of like the physical offline equivalent of that, right? It's for people that don't have that much money, or people that can't stomach a bunch of risk, like for example when flipping a house. And you can see it enables investors to make a lot of money in a short amount of time, making it a great vehicle for flipping houses. And the process involves finding properties for sale, getting them under contract, and then assigning that contract to a new buyer who's willing to buy it at a higher price. And wholesalers make money based on the percentage of the final sale, which is usually between 5 to 10%. And you can see that it does not actually involve purchasing properties, making it a great opportunity to get started in real estate without access to financing. Now, of course, this isn't financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor, but this is just an interesting way to make money when you have no money, right? And the fourth way that they talk about is partner with house flipping investors, right? That's another way that my friend got into it. He was like, okay, I just want to be a small investor in a big fish pond, right? But I want to partner with those big fishes, because I know if I put my money where their deals are, even if I have very little to no money, I could actually work with them and partner with them where, you know, I could just ask what are all the things that they don't want to do, and I'll just do those things. And that's literally in basis, like not even just in real estate, but in business in general, right? Like for example, one of our digital marketing real estate businesses is essentially just creating content, right? Like if you could see, let me just pull out, like on my blog, we literally create content about certain things. Now, what these pieces of content are, they're like addresses in the digital world, right? So this is like an address, you know, these words right here, these words are an address. And why I mean they're like an address, because for example, in the traditional, for example, commercial real estate, like if I was gonna be a dentist and I wanted to get the good piece of real estate to go ahead and open up my dental clinic, I would put it in a way where it's front of a lot of eyeballs. Same if you have a McDonald's, you'd wanna be put where there's a lot of eyeballs, right? Because then they could see your business and they could buy more of you, right? And that's where the traffic comes from. When your place, the more traffic there is in front of like a physical location, the more money this physical location will make. It's the exact same thing in the digital business, right? The more eyeballs coming to, for example, these words that people are searching for, our traffic to products that I could go ahead and sell or promote, or I could rent that space out to advertisers that want to rent my digital real estate space to go ahead and, for example, advertise their software or products or services. And you can see that's exactly how in one business we pulled in, for example, 35 to 46 grand a month with no money down. And this is with like digital real estate, right? Well, what if you don't have any money? Well, what I ended up doing is partnering with someone who had a bunch of time, but didn't have a specific opportunity. I was like, hey, just build out my digital real estate for me. And we'll partner it. Like, if you could find the deals to go ahead and, for example, sell on my digital land, we'll just split the profit. And he was like, okay, so now, like, that's really how we're building my blog, right? By partnering with someone who's investing in digital real estate. Well, you could do the exact same thing with physical real estate. Right, look at this. Both private and hard money lenders are great ways for investors to flip houses with no money down, but they are not the only ways. Additional ways is partner with house flipping investors who have problems that they don't want to solve, but you could solve them. And if you find out what the problems are and they're like, hey, we hate, you know, making lists of buyers, or hey, we hate, you know, doing the negotiations, or hey, we hate literally doing all aspects, we just want to invest our money and have someone else do the hard work, right? Do the hard work and have them invest their money. That's literally how, for example, investors in Silicon Valley think. They're like, oh, we have a bunch of money, we don't know what to do with it. There's a bunch of college kids that have all these ideas, but they don't have the money, right? So they partner together. One person has the sweat equity, the other person has the financial equity into the business. And the other one is home equity. So did you know you can actually use the equity built up in one property to purchase another? Homeowners with value in their current homes can utilize few options to get access to cash. The first way to do this is by refinancing. This involves redoing your existing mortgage and pocketing the difference between the two loans. There are no restrictions on what homeowners can do with this capital, making it for use for down payment on a fix and flip investment property, right? And you can see this, homeowners can also look at a home equity line, a HELOC, to purchase a rehab property. A HELOC operates similarly to a credit card, allowing investors to borrow against their equity and make payments every month. And this is exactly, for example, what like a lot of billionaires use, right? In terms of like, for example, tax advantage things. And of course, I'm not a tax advisor. This isn't tax advice, this isn't financial advice. But I literally looked at a video on how like the rich and ultra wealthy the other day, and how billionaires found tax advantage ways using, you know, certain equities in like the property that they own or business that they own to actually have tax advantage solutions. And it's just like an interesting thing that, wow, there's so much levels to this, you know, money game, right? But of course, as a financial advisor, I'm not a financial advisor. If you want to know faster and easier ways to make money and passive income online, though, you want to find ways that have been working for all these people that we've been teaching in all of our live events and seminars in Thailand, in Bali, and in Las Vegas, make sure you want to go and sign up for this week's free workshop below, where it's the fast and easiest way to make money fast. We literally have people go from zero to $30,000 a month faster than they ever thought was possible. As well, check out my podcast of all these really successful people that live here in Bali, like this 11-year-old girl that's trying to earn $30 million, and this guy that makes $1 million from the profit. Check it out right here. Help yourselves. Love you guys. See you guys later. Woo!